Most people in life are looking at how do I make a life that is safe from inappropriate behavior of other people. We unfortunately are in the world today facing that dilemma. The dilemma is that people are monstrously warring on people's lives. We tend to call these social media channels. They are actually utilized in business communities to do a lot of things. Originally, LinkedIn, that came around out and about in probably the year 2000, 2001, something like that, 2002-ish, literally, possibly at the latest 2003. I'm trying to remember how old I was and what I was doing when it came on board. But originally, that was a online resume center where companies could actually play in, look at your resume, and decide whether or not they wanted to hire you. Today, it's a much more robust social media tool. But we also have things like Twitter, which is an instantaneous gratification kind of things. And Kabbalah, and I'll have to look up her, I think it's Haini is her last name, wrote a wonderful book on social media, and I will post that link to this video so that you can know who I'm talking about. But what she talked about was how social media is utilized in sort of a Maslow's hierarchy of needs way for self-actualization, where people can connect to groups, people can connect to networks, and people can, in theory, improve their finances because they're making business contacts. Unfortunately, with the world of Facebook, we are being controlled completely, almost in a Nixon tape sort of way, in which we don't have the right to have our materials in front of everyone we like, and we can be booted out of looking at old friends from junior high or high school or college days, because often when we use their Google search, we cannot find who we're looking for. Even in my case, I cannot find the right access to my legal heir. Can you imagine? The woman that I'm leaving my basic, small, modest fortune, quote unquote, to, is literally not visible to me on Facebook because someone monstrously deleted the connection, both there and on LinkedIn. And it was through LinkedIn I provided her some basic information, but I have to provide her the rest of the information so she knows how to spend the $3,000, where to put me in the end, and then how to make off with the rest of a very larger sum of money. The truth is, I picked someone who was someone very special to me, someone who changed my life, you see, and someone who gave me a greater gift in the world than I could possibly ever imagine. The magic of the Lord, the magic of Jesus, the magic of paganism, perhaps, but I became a pagan because so many Christians and so many Muslims ruined my life with lies, inappropriate reporting, and totally, federally and internationally, abuses of power that violated many rights, both human rights, federal rights, constitutional rights, and amendment rights in my life. When I talk about these things, you're probably tired of hearing about it if you've listened to me ad nauseum, and I'm grateful and thankful if you do still bother to listen to me. But until the play stops, until I stop waking up in private spaces where I find a safe place in theory to lay down, and finding things that I put in one pocket found in another, or glasses going missing that were supposed to be there, or glasses broken by people who think that I should be wear, it's sort of ridiculous. We are heading into Halloween months, and people will start to think about spirituality a little bit more. They like to do things kind of mild or scary, and openly, we have a lot of new laws and ordinances to keep children safe and people safe during one of the most satanic worship holidays of the year. I don't say that ill-willed, and I don't say that willy-nilly. What I say that from is because when I lived as a child, I grew up with a FBI agent living on one side and an FBI agent living on the other side. I have to laugh a little bit about a young man who asked me the other day, after he had given me my third, honestly, sort of surprising donation to my little homeless ministry that sort of feeds me and feeds a few other people when I can, is that openly he asked me if I was with the FBI. I sort of had applied through Jess that he might be a lawman himself based on the way he handles himself, based on his slyness and sly guyness. But the truth is, after that conversation, I woke up again today with things removed from my pockets. It's an immoral thing to put your hands on someone. There are children of God who don't have fully functioning bodies or minds or understanding of maturity of hearts, souls, and again, minds, that feel impoverished enough that they have rights to do such things. The lie that they tell themselves is that they're not legally liable or federally liable or lethally liable for their inappropriate touching of other people's lives. I believe firmly that we need a brand new law about touching people while they are asleep in the night. My clothes are my clothes, and I have a right to put things in my pockets. But the most unnerving thing about this situation is that I carry some tubes inside my pants for my own personal use. And when I wake up and find the stickers that were on the tubes completely removed, and I did not do that, I'd like to know who the fuck thinks they have the right to put their hands in my pants.